Welcome to Final Cut Pro 10 in under 5 minutes. I'm Steve from RippleTraining.com. One thing that I've sorely missed from my Final Cut Pro 7 days is the ability to batch export individual clips from a timeline that includes timecode and a window burn for client review. Currently, there's no way to do this in Final Cut Pro 10, and it's one feature that's been on many editors' feature request list, including mine. The good news is, the free version of DaVinci Resolve 12 will allow you to do this, so you can do all of your editing and color grading in Final Cut, then send your project over to Resolve when you're ready to export. Here I have an open project with a few clips that I've renamed and edited as I plan on uploading these to my favorite stock footage sites. These clips have already been given a base grade using the color board. From the File menu, I'll choose Export XML. I'll leave the name as is, then save the XML file to my hard drive. With a new project open in DaVinci Resolve 12, choose File Import AAF EDL XML. Navigate to the XML file you saved and click Open. The Load XML window will appear. Make sure Automatically Set Project Settings is checked to ensure that the project that's created in Resolve matches the project settings from Final Cut Pro. If you want your color grades from Final Cut Pro handed off to Resolve, make sure to check Use Color Information. Finally, make sure Final Cut Pro 10 is selected for the Mixed Frame Rate Format option, then click OK. Click Yes to tell Resolve where your original media lives by navigating to your original media folder. But you may need to select the Final Cut Pro 10 library itself if you've exported your XML file from a managed library. Click OK. Voila! All the media is imported into the media pool, and I have a timeline with a clip string out that matches my timeline from Final Cut. One of the great things about Resolve is how easy it is to add a timecode window burn to your clips for client reviews and other purposes. Click the Color Page button at the bottom of the UI, then click the Data Burn-In button. Check the box next to Source Timecode, and a timecode window will appear over all your clips. Notice as I scrub over the clips, the window burn is displaying the actual timecode embedded in each clip. But one option I really find useful is to include the source clip name along with the timecode, so I'll check that. Okay, we're now ready to export these clips. Click the Deliver button at the bottom of the UI. To export the timeline as individual source clips, check this option. Otherwise, Resolve will spit out a single clip. Next, choose the codec you want to render to. I'll choose Apple ProRes 422. I also want all the exported clips to match the source clip's resolution, so I'll check that option as well. You can also choose to include the audio for each clip by checking this box. If you want to include the window burn, click More Options, then choose Same as Project. The last step is to choose how and where you want the file saved. To ensure that the exported file names match the timeline clip names, choose Use Source File Name. Now, choose a hard drive location by clicking Browse, then locate a drive in a folder for your export. I'll click Add New Folder, then name the folder Diving Clips with Burn, then click OK. To export your clips, click the Add to Render Queue button, then click Start Render in the Render Queue panel. Resolve dutifully renders, then exports each clip to your designated folder. When the process is completed, go to the Finder and you'll see your individual clips with window burn that match the clip names and time code from Final Cut Pro 10. For those of you who want to learn more about Resolve's media management and grading capabilities, check out our DaVinci Resolve 12 Quick Start, available on our website.